just write the best work that you can, and don't wait for permission from anyone. Don't worry about whether or not you're gonna be validated by a white, cis, patriarchal culture. Like, fuck that culture. Do the kind of work that you wanna do, and then make the cultural change you wanna see.
And surely Felicia King is more than just a 25-year-old Thai Australian playwright. She's a hilarious, hardworking, multidisciplinary artist with the worldview of someone who has lived 1,000 lives. From creating plays featuring all female, all Asian casts to having her work shown across the globe, Felicia opens up about the difficulty in having her success reduced to her identity politics or young age. From her thoughts on Crazy Rich Asians to the story behind her new legal drama, Golden Shield, Felicia is a trailblazer in Australian theatre who doesn't wait for permission. She gives it to herself and gets it done.
You have to be the person who makes it, because you can't sit around waiting for opportunities to be afforded to you. And part of that is operating at a level of like artistic rigor and excellence, you know, proving that we're not just making work for our own communities, we're making work for everybody, and fighting really hard to make sure that we're in the kinds of platforms where we're visible.
Can you tell us a little bit about Golden Shield?
The play is based on a number of real court cases. Chinese plaintiffs sued American tech companies for their purported collusion in helping to build the Golden Shield, which is the development policy that's now synonymous with online censorship in China. And the core of the play is really this relationship between two Chinese-American sisters, one of whom is a lawyer on one of these cases, and one of whom is her translator, and them navigating their complicated familial relationship as a metaphor for the like crazy big issues in the play.
Who is your target audience when you're writing?
I think ultimately I am writing for sort of like young Asian women, young women of color. People who come see the work have the same experiences that I have when I'm in the theater and see myself being represented, or see something that makes me go like, oh, I didn't know stories could be told like that. I didn't know that I could be, people like me could be on stage in that way.
I didn't know there could be a play with an all-female, all-Asian
cast. Yeah, exactly. I feel a real responsibility as an artist, and an artist who is lucky enough to work in different places around the world, to make sure that I am pushing that conversation and creating a sort of like a paradigm shift in every institution that I'm working in.
You've taken the words out of my mouth. I literally wrote down here, from an outside perspective, I feel like you carry a lot of responsibility on your shoulders to explore ethics, politics, diversity. I imagine that sometimes it gets a little exhausting.
Totally. It's unfortunate that so often the burden of this kind of like emotional labor and advocacy falls on people who are historically marginalized. But I also feel very strongly that it's an enormous privilege to get to do it. And part of the impetus for writing White Pearl, which is this sort of like all Asian female cast, and even writing plays like this for bilingual actors, was just people I knew who weren't getting work and I knew were brilliant because I was in a grad school environment with them, and I was like, this is unfair. One of the things that fuels me as an artist, oddly enough, is a sense of like injustice and sort of healthy levels of rage at sort of mainstream white institutions and the complacency that comes with them. And even, you know, seeing stuff like Crazy Rich Asians and Always Be My Maybe and these sort of like, one, I think that like the level of solidarity that I saw around those films and the way that the Asian community responded to it, it's so heartening to people, and it's heartening to me to see that happening. But also, I think that there are more complex stories that we can be telling within our own community, and we should be aspiring to more.
A lot of the subjects, the genres, are still a little bit two-dimensional.
Totally. You can't cast actors in complicated parts if the complicated parts aren't there.
Damn.
Yeah.
We need more writers of color who are aspiring to write more complex work, so that we can have nuanced representation of people of color, so it isn't all saccharine capitalist fever dreams. If you write a good story with people who are interesting and complex, it doesn't matter what they look like or where they come from. It is universal innately, I think.
It's human.
Right, exactly, and therefore universal.
And do a lot of people ask you about your age?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's something that people have sort of latched onto. And it's very weird. I think in Western cultures, we sort of idolize youth and success in youth in a way that I find a little problematic. I feel that there are a lot of expectations and pressures on my work to succeed, but also it often gets reduced to my personal identity politics in terms of being young, being a woman of color. Where possible, I try and reframe the narrative to actually be about my work.
Do you feel those conversations are slowly changing in Australia?
Slowly changing, slowly being the operative word there, you know. In an ideal world, I think Australian theatre looks more like Australia, you know? It's more diverse. And I hope that we can be part of a global conversation while celebrating our own uniqueness as a culture.
And could you have predicted any of this?
No. I know, I really could. I mean, all I ever wanted my entire life was just to be an artist and subsist, you know, not have to work like a shitty day job as a barista. And now that I have that, I am constantly having to reevaluate what my goals are.
Okay, let's make a prediction then.
Okay.
Right now.
Okay.
Where do you think you'll be in 5 years?
Fuck. That's a terrifying question.
Yep.
I hope that I'm still making a living as an artist, where I can look back and go like, here's all of that cultural change that I can see like palpably. The only thing we're qualified to do as an artist, because we're not experts in the fields that we talk about, the only thing we're really qualified to do is ask moral questions, actually, without necessarily needing to have clear didactic answers. I don't feel like it's a blanket moral imperative for everybody, but for me it's very important.
Hey there, my name is Mark Fennell, and if you enjoyed that, and I'm hoping that you did, then make sure you like and subscribe to the Feed's YouTube channel, and definitely watch that thing that I have absolutely seen before. It's really good.